We do so much stuff, it's amazing.
Then we'll sit down and make the house of cards, remember?
Yep.
Yeah. Exactly. He'll bring you all the cards and you'll be making the house of cards, and then they'll never fall down.
I spent probably since what I can remember in and out of hospitals. My dad was Icelandic and my mom is Ecuadorian. Because my parents always thought I was sick and didn't trust Western medicine, essentially, they flew me to like witch doctors in South America, specialists in Switzerland, you name it. I was probed, poked, and given possibly everything you can imagine. I fell into a terrible depression, became suicidal, developed body issues. It's not about the me, sad story. It's about the me. I feel so damn good because I eat better now than I ever have. When you eat an amazing meal with someone, what do you remember? Do you remember the conversation? Do you remember the ambiance? Because what I take away is a feeling.
Indianapolis may just be the hidden mecca for the gluten-free community. But it wouldn't be that way if it weren't for Shalia Cafferty. Shalia organizes huge gluten-free expos where hundreds of vendors come and share their products with thousands of people in the community. I had the pleasure and opportunity at the last one to come do cooking demos and lecture on gluten-free lifestyle.
I've met people change their life just by going gluten-free who don't need to be, and they freak out. They're like, my skin glows, I'm not tired, it's amazing. I'm like, okay, Diva Central, let's take it elsewhere.
When I told Shalia I wanted to do something special this holiday season for those in need, she set me up with Beacon of Hope, an organization that helps battered women and children get back on their feet.
Everywhere I go, before a trip, I always sit down and I pack my food. When you get on a plane, put them in Ziploc bags. No TSA agent can take any food away from you if it's not a liquid. Oh, here we go.
As soon as I landed in Indianapolis, Shalia scooped me up and took me to her psychic gym.
Well, you got a lot of stuff going on, girl, for next year. Normally we only talk 6 months out, but yours is going all to a year. When August comes around, you're going to probably be a nonstop. When I say you're on the go, you're probably going to have to do most of this by yourself because you are very emotional, but yet you refuse to always acknowledge your feelings. Sometimes you're good at burying those feelings. And when you do that, then you sort of shortchange yourself. Just because I think that I desire something, there somebody else may present something that I don't feel is attached to that desire, but it can be attached to the desire. And so this is just like another piece of the pie for you, okay? By the way, do you bake pies at all?
Not really. I mean,
I didn't think so, but there's something about the pie, and there's really not a lot of planning here. It's just going to happen. And your challenge is sometimes your mind goes off in the, I've got to go here, and I call the spirit world has you directed over here.
I am no stranger to psychics. Growing up with an Icelandic father who is fascinated by the paranormal, psychics, clairvoyance, the other world, past lifetimes. This was something that was a relationship and bond that we shared and sought out together.
Can I ask, is my dad one of those people?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he was just outside the door. He said, thanks for calling me in. He says, I want you to relax more because you are always pushing and sometimes you get a little uptight about business. He said that you are a great go-for-it girl. He laughs at you. He says, oh yeah. He says, don't put you on a mission because you probably accomplish it. You're like the hound dog that gets on the trail and doesn't give up until he finds what he's looking for, okay? And so he really thinks you're pretty cool. Sometimes we also just need loving, supporting people, even though they're not physically, they're still there nonetheless. And you will sense and feel that support. And that's what your dad's here for. Your dad doesn't have to be underfoot, he said. He will come every time you need him. Because if you really would like him, just call for him, okay?
My life changed in the past year and a half. This is the second Christmas without my dad. We couldn't reverse stage 4 malignant melanoma. But what we did is, you know, we brought him a lot of peace, brought him a lot of energy, made him really happy. His hair went from white to brown. And that was through the food that I was making him. My dad made me promise him, he's like, you know what, I know you love what you do, you're really good at it, but you need to follow your true path, which is helping people through food. I had cervical cancer 5 years ago. It's been 5 years since then, and I'm totally fine. But I also eat, you know, very well. I take care of myself.
One of you was a man and one was a woman in a lifetime. I think you were the man and you were the girl or female.
Were
but
we together?
Not very much in it. That was just kind of a brief encounter.
This.
Yeah.
What? Whoa. What? I always knew that Shalee and I were close. I just never knew how close we were.
After visiting with a psychic, we went to go grocery shopping. For those times when you have a craving, like you want a donut, don't go to Dunkin' Donuts. You want to go to a nature's farm.
Do you feel like the people that come in are on the diet because they feel better or just because they're trying a trend?
I guess there's both, because a lot of people with autistic children who have tried gluten-free diets because it's supposed to help them out like tremendously. And like over the years they've gotten like a lot better. So we get like people like that who are like dedicated gluten-free families. And then there's people that I think gluten is synonymous with bad, which is not, you know.
Like
not
ice necessary.
Cream?
Like
yeah.
You'll notice that all the food that we did was mostly whole foods. Now, when you're trying to go on an allergy-free diet, this is really the best way to feel better and also save a ton of money. Somehow we got in our head to go as far as we can, as fast as we can, but we still don't understand the reasons why it just isn't worth. After we finished shopping, we headed to the church where we would be having the event. To my amazement, my sous chef was a college-age kid who was interested in cooking. So it wasn't really the sous chef I was expecting, but I do have to say it was better than any sous chef I could have expected because he had more passion and drive.
The last time I was like doing anything like this, like I freaked out my neighbor. She's like, oh, what are you doing with the chicken? And a Julia Child thing would be, she would take it up and she'd be like, make the chicken bounce because it relaxes him. And then you're going to rub it around. I'm going to be doing the rounds.
While Pete doesn't know much about living with allergies, he does know a lot about the hardship of losing a loved one to an illness.
Heart disease got to him eventually. What happened was, it's a long process story, but he was supposed to get a LVAD, which is like a battery pack that attaches to your heart. Uh-huh. But the first thing they had to do was, you know, amputate some of his toes because he had an infection. But it kept not taking, so it kept having to go higher and higher up on his leg. And they couldn't do the LVAD until it healed. But then infection got to him before he could get the LVAD, so it was like the most It was the most pointless process in the world, basically. But I want to avoid heart disease, that's why I eat healthy and cook healthy all the time.
We brined turkeys, we prepped so many vegetables, and even ate a diet gluten-free pizza.
And you're not gluten-free, right?
No.
So, and it's good?
Yeah,
you
like
it?
I'd eat it regularly.
No bullshit?
No bullshit. Used to take a longer time to understand
my point. What means somebody's lonely? Company means there are two. Three means a crowd and it's about to get loud. We threw the turkeys in the oven. We finished mashing all the potatoes and I decided to show Pete that not all allergy-free food has to taste like crap. I even showed him how to make my favorite fresh pasta using a spiralizer and fresh zucchini. This meat and potatoes kid was amazed and so excited to be eating it. The
As we finished prepping for the event, we started to put out all the food, and this was truly the magic hour. All the 20 families that we had been prepping this holiday meal for started to pour in, and you could sense the gratefulness in their faces. When they shared their stories with me, I have never felt so touched in my entire life. Serving the food was fun, but getting to see the guests' faces, getting to bring a group of people together for a nice home-cooked meal, truly warmed my heart as much as it warmed their bellies. The clients from Beacon of Hope's faces could not be shown due to safety reasons. Some of their stories are so crazy, I could hardly believe my ears.
Time that you read my mind, I took it as a sign.
We let them know that you do not deserve this kind of treatment. You only need to be in a relationship that's nurturing and gentle and not abusive and threatening to kill you, and you need to get out. We had a client come in to our center to get counseling, and she says, I'm being stalked by my husband, who is an Ethiopian king. Well, he calls her and he said, you know, I don't know where you are, but I know you're someplace where a lighthouse is. And it was like, okay, this is kind of, because she kept telling us that when she was in stalls going to the bathroom, he would know where she was. I went and did some research on the internet for microchips. And what happened was when I came back into the counseling room, he had called like 3 times. And our counselor was really getting spooked, you know? So we asked her to take all her jewelry off, her shoes, her hair breadths, everything. So we called the police, and the police came out. She had a microchip in her shoes, and she had one in her steering column in her car, and that's how he was tracking her. We actually had a client call us just a couple weeks ago, and she says, well, I went back to him, but she says, I'm ready to get out. Will you help me? And we're right there for them.
The most shocking part of all was to see just how many convince themselves that they are not victims of abuse, when in fact, from the outside perspective, it is quite obvious how much abuse they have taken. Terry herself is a survivor of domestic violence, so she can understand firsthand what her clients are going through and is able to help them from that perspective, which is extremely helpful for her clients to open up.
Right.
But you gave so much. No. You know, I mean, really, yeah. Jackie and Josh, if you guys hadn't done this, no. It would have been nice, but it wouldn't have been.
It wouldn't have been like this, no. No.
Everybody, Suzanne, Jackie, they're all saying this was the best. Mm-hmm. And we've got you to be.
Like a fine wine improves with time. Our love will grow stronger further down the line. Yes, it will stand the test.
The next morning, I had just enough time before my flight to meet another friend of Shalia's, who is a holistic doctor.
And all of a sudden, I looked at my life, and I had four boys, two of which were diagnosed as ADHD, one that had significant learning disabilities, another one that I was told was on the spectrum for autism and had Asperger's. My husband was diagnosed with epilepsy following his brain tumor and had gained 30 pounds and was exhausted, would fall asleep at the drop of a hat. I, over that time, had been diagnosed with markers for lupus, pretty devastating disease as it progresses. And I was sick all the time and I didn't feel good. And I took a step back and looked at my life and said, there's something seriously wrong with what we're doing. I just poured myself into learning about how diet can impact your health. With a few arguments with my husband, decided I was gonna change some diets. and my kids didn't like it very much, but I pulled out all gluten, dairy, all common allergens, and within 3 weeks I had the school calling me. Two different teachers called me about my son and said, what's the matter? They were concerned because he was actually acting appropriately, because normally he would be irritating his neighbor or tapping his thing. And basically what I had done was change our diet and add in some basic nutrients that were missing. It's not traditional medicine.
We're using whole ingredients like zucchini.
You come in with a symptom, when you go to your doctor, you want your script, you want to feel better tomorrow, and I can't promise that. If we work together, we partner together, and we do this together, you are going to feel better.
So I'm going to add half of these beautiful nudskis, add them in, and literally, I'm just going to let them sit there for about 2 shakes. And the carrots you can kind of leave in a little bit longer because they are a little bit more fibrous. You want to make sure just to kind of let it chill in the ice water, because basically what this does is it stops the cooking process. You want to be gentle with this because this is not something where it's wham bam, thank you ma'am.
But functional medicine is like peeling back the layers of an onion. So you peel back one thing and something else pops up.
To this we're going to add a tiny bit of red wine vinegar, nothing special, a little bit of lemon zest.
But sometimes it's a whole conglomeration of a life that you have to undo.
This is so fresh.
About 6% of the population, they believe, has a gluten sensitivity. What I find is that there is no nutritional value in gluten or dairy that's necessary that you can't get somewhere else. At the end of the day, my patients, by the time we get to a place where they're really feeling well, they don't want it in their life. So I ask people to remove it because it doesn't add anything.
Gluten-free lifestyle has been like, it's not a fad for me, it's something that I've been on for the last like 12, 13 years, and I take it very seriously because I know there's so many people out there with health issues and health problems, and their life is so much better because they're on the gluten-free diet. You know, when I ingest gluten, I have to say I get depressed, and then I suffer from bloating, and just generally I don't feel good, and yeah, I'm not afraid to say, yeah, gluten makes me depressed, and I am so much better without it, and I will never go back to it. And my husband, to support me, also is on the gluten-free diet, and he actually says he prefers it.
This is a big freaking deal. This is the difference between being really, you know, freaking depressed versus like really enjoying your life, and you're like one of the most vibrant, fun
which
people
would you
I
rather
know.
Do, right?
Yeah.
I've heard others that will step off the diet, you know, here and there, and you know, and splurge on stuff, but I really don't because I know the impact that that has on my body and my health. The idea that healing ourselves through food, which is what you do, and the passion that you put into it, and really trying to, you know, empower people to eat healthy, I think that's really an amazing path that you're taking.
Above all anything I'm saying, if the biggest thing you can take away is care about yourself more than anything, so you can truly give to others, I live to serve. Like, I live to give and raise awareness and educate. That's what makes me wake up every day.
It's amazes me in the short amount of time since we've been doing the show for the past 3 years, how the expo has kind of grown and morphed and evolved into something that's so big. We have lectures on celiac disease and gluten sensitivity, and then vendors come from around the country. What the expo does for the gluten-free community is it gives them a chance to try the product before they buy it, because you know how expensive gluten-free products are. It's really an added benefit to be able to come and try these things that you may have been thinking about buying but you're not sure about because you haven't tried it yet. In that sense, I think it empowers them.
Each one of you here is worth more than any winning lottery ticket. You know why? Because you're here today in this very moment. There's a lot of people that wish they could be or would pay X amount of $1 billion to have someone else sitting right next to them. So we have the gift of life. Take care of it. These vehicles, this old bag I'm wearing, I'm gonna take the best care of this shit that I can because it's the only bag that I got.
myself.